Of Hungary in red. I am Hannah Pendlebury, joined in the booth today by Ravi Vasudevan. Ravi, how are you doing today?
Doing very good, very excited to start this championship event off. Lovely, good Hungary here hosting us, and we're going to see things starting off as Austria start off on offense this first point. Hungary really stopping them, been a lot of passes, and they have not been able to move forward very much so far.
Yeah, a bit of a zonal look to start the game from Hungary. Austria nice and patient. These two teams have met before earlier in the season. Austria getting the win both times. We'll talk a bit more about those games as the match develops. Oh, cheeky hammer over the top into the center. Meisner on the disc. They have to reset to the handlers. Nice use of the aerial throws by Austria. Not really much wind at the moment here in the stadium. Seems to be generating some flow upfield now. More players from Austria in the middle of the pitch. That's going to be a risky biscuit, but up goes the hand of number 25, David Hütter. And a score for Austria. First point on the board to open up this tournament.
David Hütter there, one of the more experienced players on this team, played back in the days of Upsa Daisy, back when Austria was a much stronger mixed national nation. See here on our roster sheet that David Hütter has actually played for longer than the youngest player, his youngest teammate has been alive, so a lot of experience there, and great stuff from the Austrians, able to work through that zone and make it 1-0 to start this thing off.
Yeah, that was a really nice patience from the Austrian side there, Rav.
It was good pressure from the Hungarians. They really forced Austria to swing it a lot, and Austria was only able to get things going by blading over the top to open things up. And there was quite a risky shot to David Hütter, who eventually broke through that zone. So good pressure by the Austrians, forced them into some uncomfortable situations, but in the end, Austria was able to prevail. So we'll get our first look here at the Hungarian offensive line as Austria looked to pull for the second point of the game.
As we briefly mentioned, there is no wind here really to speak of in this game. As you see that lovely flat pull going nice and deep, fielded by Marton. We see quite a deep horizontal stack from the Hungarian side. Crowd here in the stands getting loud for that layout bid attempt from Austria.
We are here on the Hungarian sideline as this big shot goes up.
And that's a beautiful piece of field vision. Scoring opportunity ripe for Hungary right now. Oh, and another inside shot, but smacked down. That's a fabulous piece of defense.
Great grab there by the Hungarian receiver, but not able to turn it into a goal as now Austria will get their first chance for a break.
So, again, we see this zone look. Hungary choosing to mark the space rather than the players. Big force on the mark. That's can't quite spy the number from our perch up here in the stands, but that's a big old mark. I think that's number 15, Gabor Spazo.
Austria very stagnant right now, not doing a lot downfield to get things moving. Hungary going into this zone look again, trying to slow the Austrians down.
Oh, nice hammer fake there. Hannah's happy to move it now, being a bit more aggressive, opening up the space downfield. 26 near side, that's Pack. Nice movement. Dovitz playing a central hand the role here. Montgomery, nice pop over the top to Schmeisser. Back into the hands of Dovitz. Three Hannah's just happy to trot round the back right now. Pack to Dovitz. Back to Pack. Ooh, little, maybe a bubble there in the chest, but keeps it alive. Nice. Gentle, easy swinging, patience bounce. Oh, and a blade from Dovitz. Oh, and a sneaky, isolated player, Saklefti, in the back corner. Austria take a break. Second score of the game, leading 2-0.
It's the second time we've seen this Hungarian zone come out, and it is forcing Austria into a lot of passes, but it's not really causing any pressure to the Austrian offense. They have to swing it around, but every time they swing it around, it's a wide open pass. We saw a little bobble there, but they're able to hold on to it, and eventually they just work it around until they find that bladey pass. Without this wind here, it doesn't look like that zone's going to be too effective in stopping Austria. It slows them down, but I'm not sure it's going to generate too many turns as Austria go up 2-0 and they take their first break of the game.
Yeah, it's an interesting call, as we say, that the conditions aren't really right for playing zone, especially against teams with such experienced handler sets. But I do love the spice of the inside shots. That inside flick huck, Ravi, to get that space, just... my goodness, lots of players think they have that throw, but not many do.
You're right there. It's definitely good stuff we've seen these first 2 points. We will see Hungary come out now. They're a bit of a younger team, an average age of 18.5 on this team. So a lot to work for, a lot of long-term vision here on the Hungarian side. We'll see what they can manage to do with a big supporting side. We are on the Hungarian stadium right now, on the Hungarian side of the stadium.
And I think they heard you as we see them put up a big huck with a drum behind us. Bit of contact there, but that just seems like a plain old misread.
I think that was a catchable disc, but as you said, just a misread there. Contact not really affecting play, so good spirit by the Hungarians not calling anything as Austria will get a chance for another break in this game.
Looks like Hungary once again setting up that zone look. We talked about the fact that they're a bit of a younger team. Definitely very athletic. I think it's an interesting thing to see them play this zone. Obviously, playing person defense, they perhaps maybe have the edge to be a bit more athletic, but they'll stick with it as the Austrians now move it through. Looking at a high stall there. Olds manages to pop it off. Again, we see three Austrian handlers back. Just very patient. Chilled out offense. Nice movement. Aggressive from the handlers. Fine separation downfield. Great work from number 69, Benjamin Kane. Really spreading the defense. Well, that's a high shot, but into plenty of space. Up goes the disc once again. But that's just a bit of an errant throw. Fabulous separation finds Frengel, but unfortunately, it doesn't come up with the goods.
This is exactly what that Hungarian defense is trying to do. It's trying to get Austria into throwing lots of passes, not exactly the most comfortable options that you would in person-to-person defense, and eventually hope that a mistake will be made. They're not going to get the D, but maybe they can wait until Austria makes a mistake. It worked out this time, and we'll see if they can do things a bit more on offense here.
And now instead of a zone, we see a poach in the open lane from Austria. A defensive bid there from Teresa Olds. But it appears to be a bit of a discussion.
I do see the two players seem to have caught it somewhat simultaneously. It's hard to judge which player got there first. Of course, if it's a tie, it will go to the offense. And it does look like Hungary is going to keep possession here.
Suddenly.
Some call was retracted there. Maybe the defensive player was calling a strip and that got retracted. I'm not sure.
In any case, the Austrian poach seems to have disappeared. Now just playing straight person defense. Hungary using their women to great effect, but that's a bit of a lofty one. Well received. Bit of a collateral friendly fire upfield as the fans in the stands get excited. Nice round break to the near side of the field. Bogar surveys her options. Not looking like she likes much. Nice reaching grab. Oh, and there's a big putt. Tipped on it, but that is a score for Hungary.
Hungary get themselves on the board there with a nice risky blade shot as they're able to reel one in. You see the crowd is absolutely loving it. They were cheering for every single pass that Hungary is able to complete this point. And Hungary able to make it 2-1. Not the cleanest of points for the Hungarians, but their zone paid off. They finally were able to get the disc back, and there was a tipped D on that throw, but every point counts the same. 2-1 now.
Yeah, that's great composure from the number 21. Adam Slazlocki. You'll have to forgive our pronunciation. We did try and get a bit of a hand from one of the lovely ambulance volunteers here. And as you say, Ravi, even with fingertips on the disc, Austria couldn't prevent that Hungarian score. So the team in white now leading 2-1 in this match. Ravi, we mentioned the fact that these two teams have met earlier on this season. How did those two previous matches pan out?
They were two practice matches. Both teams were also at Talampaya earlier this season, but they didn't match up there. They had some practice games, though, where Austria came out on top 15-8 and 15-3. So it does seem that Austria is a bit of the stronger side here, but Hungary's going to have their whole home country backing them in this opening match, so we'll see if that can play their way as they seem to be playing quite with them so far in this game. But we will see Austria's O-line come out here as Hungary comes into that zone again.
Yeah, the number 25, David Hutter, fielding the pull to the rick mark there. He's been playing ultimate longer than the youngest player on this Australian team. Nice hammer over the top. Again, we'll see nice patient offense through this Hungarian zone. Faking and throwing the hammers. Shit there in the middle. To Mesner. Good moving through, but there is a bit of an error there as the number 10, Anja Vilavica, unfortunately out of bounds.
Just poor field awareness there. I don't know if she maybe was looking at that, you know, spectator 3 meter line thinking the field ran all the way out there because she completely thought she was in bounds, but was a good meter out of it as we see a first big scooper from the Hungarians as they try to get their first break of this game.
Still a bit of clustering upfield from the Hungarian offense, but this is very nice. Up goes the shot. Two players, miles free underneath it, and that is a second score and a break back for Hungary.
That was a fantastic throw. Great touch there on that flick from Hungary. Really good stuff here. I was expecting this to be a bit more of a blowout, but they're playing really quite good offensively. Like you said, a little clustered downfield, but they're eventually taking the shots that they're given and showing Austria their deep game earlier in this game. That's really important in these types of matches because if you just play under, 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 eventually the team will be able to shut that down. Hungary now has shown our deep game is good, and that's going to force Austria to play a bit more on the deep game, which will open up the unders later on in this game. We'll see how that plays out as Hungary equalize things here. One break apiece, 2-2, in favor. Austria still with the lead on serve right now.
Indeed, so as you say, we get this game back on serve. Lovely score from Szabo, picking up his first goal of the game. Currently, stats-wise, we've seen all three assists from Hungary coming from Paksai Marton. Clearly a capable thrower, but that's one of the things I really like about this Hungarian side, is the fact that they're for quite a young team, have quite a throwing skill set. We've seen scubas, we've seen some really I mean, I'm still recovering from how beautiful that inside flick Huck was for their first score. That was just, well, sorry, no, it wasn't the score in the end, I take it back. But that was still, like, credit to them. They're coming out and putting out some big shots, as you say, opening up the space deep. We'll have to wait to see how this one continues to develop as Austria have the disc in hand. Stossel.
So we do see Hungary coming out into a match. No, this is still a junky look. It looked like match defense for a second there, but I was wrong about that. Still doing the zone. I think they are changing their zones up a bit. They have one defender marking a handler and then maybe trying to take Hutzer out of the game.
This seems like a wise choice. This seems to be one of the key parts of this Austrian unit.
Sorry, it's Leon Dovitz they're trying to take out of the game here. As Hungary get another defensive play and might be able to take themselves up a break if they can capitalize on this, Hannah.
Fantastic heads up from Jonathan Harsanyi. See if Hungary can put something in here. A little tumble. Lots of contact on the mark on that far side of the field.
Stall out ball.
Yeah. That is the excellent use of hand signals over there. Unfortunately for Hungary, couldn't find much upfield, and that'll be a great feeling for Sean Montgomery. Not often you see stallouts in championship level games.
Usually don't see uncontested stallouts in championship level games, that's for sure.
Yep. Well, fabulous spirit from everyone on the field so far. All of the calls going very quickly discussed. And Austria with an opportunity to take back that break they earned earlier in the game. Great coverage from Hungary. Oh, and there's the run through deep. Number two for Jonathan Harsanyi.
Great presence of mind.
Error on the throw. Devastating. Austria. Opportunity blade over the top. That makes it 3-2.
Still on serve here with Austria holding there. Hungary getting two defensive plays in that point, though, and really frazzling this Austrian offensive line and causing a lot more pressure than I was expecting them to be able to this game.
Player of that point, definitely number 96 for Hungary, Jonathan Harsanyi, really getting up in the mixer, getting those blocks, but just goes to show the youth of this team can really get in there, get the Ds, but unfortunately don't seem to have quite the capabilities to maybe put together their offense right now. It'd be really good to see them coming up and using that energy on both sides of the disc.
So we see another defensive play.
And a rather indoors throw there, that blade for the score for Austria.
Like you said, very still conditions out here and against this Hungarian zone. That's the kind of throws that are opening things up for Austrians. If they just try and swing it around, they're eventually getting deed. But when they can get over the top, that's where they break things open, as we see Hungary come out on offense with a scuba of their own.
That's a nice throw to Bogard. Hungary with their stack really, really deep. Bogard. The sideline has an upline cut, but doesn't seem to be that convincing it. Nice throws over the top to open up the break side for the handlers. A big one goes up once more to that fading break side, and that is a score for Hungary, tying it up with 3 apiece.
Great presence of mind there by Julia Halatz to take that one in. Great spacing on her cut and great throw. That was back in the back corner. Not an easy throw to make, but put it exactly where only the receiver could get to it. Very good handler movement, very good throwing prowess we're seeing out of this Hungarian side so far this game. Great opening throws also throughout that point by number 37, Sanadi Bogar, who's a player who I noticed last year. I played against Hungary Mixed at Windmill. She was a very star player on that team back then, and we see her taking a lot bigger of a throwing role than she did last time. And look at that great inside shot there from Hungary.
Well, we already mentioned the thrower, the number 10, Paksai Marton. That's the third assist. He has been distributing all of Hungary's scores thus far. So clearly someone you need to put your hands very low when you're marking.
As we do see, a timeout is called here on the field, I believe by Austria, but I'm not sure. See Coach Zoltan out there, well joining the circle for Austria, as well as the mascots, Hugo, the chicken. You're a big fan of Hugo, aren't you?
I'm a huge fan of Hugo. We've got two Hugos currently present at this opening match. The lovely individuals in the mascot costumes who must be absolutely sweltering. We have talked about the lack of wind, but what we haven't talked about is the heat and the sunshine. It is absolutely glorious here today at these fields. And thankfully we've got a natural surface rather than if we were playing on the artificial turf, which, I mean, that's going to be a heck of a sweatbox. There is one artificial turf field here, which we'll actually be bringing you coverage from the stadium field and that artificial field all throughout this week. How can we tune into those streams, Ravi?
So the streams that are going to be on this field, on the main field, will only be available on fanseat.com. So you're going to have to be subscribed to Fanseat. It'll be behind a paywall. But the games on the other field, in the artificial turf field, Field 2, will be streamed on Fanseat, but as well as the EUF Facebook and the EUF YouTube channel for free. So you'll be able to get those ones for free. But the main streams on Field 1 through Fanseat, lots of games to watch this whole week.
And we have to say the newly overhauled, brand spanking new interface of Fanseat, which is very exciting. I haven't quite seen it yet, but I'm looking forward to it. But make sure that you'll get your subscription, even if only for the 1 month, just so you can enjoy all the coverage here at the European Ultimate Championships here in Győr, Hungary.
Working on your Győr there.
I am. It's challenging. It's challenging.
We're going to get there. We're going to get there by the end of the week.
Győr. Shout out to Rachel Toshnerova, who's been helping us out with our Eastern Bloc pronunciations.
She might get herself on the mic sometime this week. We'll have to see.
Yes, indeed. Well, she'll certainly be on the stream tomorrow afternoon, latest game slot. She'll be playing, representing her home nation of the Czech Republic. But to focus back on this mixed game in front of us, Hungary running down the field to try and prevent an Austrian hold, as we see once again this zone look from the young team in red. Number 93, Meissner. Lots of diss time for the Austrian handlers.
This is what I think Austria's not doing particularly well against this zone. They're holding onto the disc for 3, 4, 5 stall counts, allowing that 1-3 setup to kind of clamp down, as opposed to moving them around, trying to get them tired. This is a young team. They're gonna have legs under them, but if we can get them tired sprinting around the field, it's gonna open things up later in this game. We'll see how it plays as Austria goes from over the top.
Yeah, Austria are really playing right now, Ravi. Like, they've got a lead. That conservative, really chilled out, some might argue potentially a bit snooze-worthy type of offense. I quite like it. I'm being a handler myself, I favor the, you know, lots of touches, just playing a bit of keep disc. But they're playing a little bit like they're up, and I have to say, you need to run the Hungarians around more and see if you can tire them out. But they're being effective. They're working it down the field slowly, patiently, clearly. The number 4, faking the hammers, back to Meissner. A bit more energy now in the handler set as they go up line to expose the central space. Keneally pops back. Filavica. Huta. Rolly backhand to that far side. Back to Huta. Got a big wingspan, able to break around.
This is more what I like to see. They've swung it all the way across the field in a couple of passes, but quickly. And trying to open up space by tiring out that Hungarian zone.
And by moving it around, really exploiting those central spaces. So we see Hungary stick to their zone. Austria on the goal line. Takes the easy dump pass. Hungary still sticking to that zone, even so close to the end zone.
I actually like that look. It seems to be slowing Austria down. They've had many passes to score and haven't managed to do so yet.
Faking off the around swing, choosing the risky biscuit inside.
What I also like about this Hungarian zone is that they're taking a lot of women and putting them in the front cup, which is allowing, you know, if you have a lot of male handlers, which Austria has now shifted out of that, you end up with a lot of good gender mismatches downfield with men on women. So it's great effective mixed strategy to put fast women in the cup and allow bigger height mismatches downfield.
Indeed, a bit of goaltending, but can't prevent another isolated player in the deep part of the end zone. Austria with a hold, score now 4-3.
And again, Austria's only option to beat this zone so far has been over the top. They're able to swing it around. There's not a lot of pressure. They're not going to, you know, get a forced defense against them when they're swinging, but they're not able to move forward. Hungary's doing a great job of pushing them out of forward passes. The only way they're able to get through is going over the top, and so far it's been effective, but, you know, that does increase the risk factor and eventually causes a few turns, which this Hungarian zone has, to their credit, been able to do so far this game.
And they did have some short field opportunities for the scores, but I think it's the idea also of they're getting into the heads of the Austrian offense and just making them play in that kind of, you know, just swinging it, looking off the ones right in front of you. Just like, it's trying to confuse the Austrian offense, perhaps, and try and get them in that mode where they might make an error or they might not choose the opportunities. But certainly it feels better, I think, as a defender to be able to make a national level O-line take that long to score.
Especially right in front of their end zone there. That was maybe, what, 30 passes they had from their attacking brick mark to that goal. Probably more, maybe 30 or 40 passes that it took them to score. So indeed, that should be really, really, really good for the Hungarian defense.
There's a reaching grab, but unfortunately not to be for Anna Patzendorf, one of two Patzendorf siblings on this team, joined by her brother Mata. And there's an easy score from Austria up that far line. That's a break of score off a costly early error.
And this is the issue we're going to see with this Hungarian team. They are a bit young, they are a bit green, they're going to make errors like this throughout the game. So far, they hadn't made any, you know, really bad ones at this point of the game, but that's going to cost him 5-3 now as Austria start to pull away a little bit. Just noting on our stats board from that previous point when we were talking about that Hungarian zone defense, it actually took Austria 57 passes to score that one.
And that is a heck of a lot of passes. Nice high. Is that a lefty break there? I think it was. That is gorgeous. Welcome if you are just joining us. We're here at the European Ultimate Championships here in Győr, Hungary. We have action from the mixed division. Two of 54 teams here at this tournament. There are 15 women's teams, 20 men's teams, and 19 mixed teams. But the host nation's mixed team in front of us in red versus Austria in the white. Again, we see the Hungarian stack very deep, but coming through. Nice big backhand, but that's going to be peeled off by Austria. And we see, for the first time, Ravi, a person defense from Hungary. This is very exciting.
It's a bit of a shame on that previous possession. They had athletic separation throughout the point, but just had a bit of an errant pass there. It seemed like they really were getting open into space and weren't getting too much trouble from the Austrian defense, but now Austria puts up a big one.
And that is a break of score for Austria. As you say, real shame. There was really nice separation, but just a bit of a I think a bit of a hasty backhand from Hungary. Just really dialed in the throw, really just put it out for basically anyone to catch it. It just happened to be that Austria got under there with a rather large chap.
Yeah, I think that's the kind of thing that you're going to see with inexperience on this team. They're going to get better over the next few years at this, but right now they are athletically playing with Austria, it has to be said, but some of the decision-making not quite there. And Austria's capitalizing right now as they go up to a 6-3 lead and start to pull away with this as a little train of breaks. That's the second break in a row for Austria right now.
And then we actually see Austria using what I would probably say is Hungary's favorite part of the field, that far break side and the right-hand end zone corner, attacking it with backhands rather than insides. But I was excited to see them play a bit of person match defense. Really enjoyed watching the kind of just seeing the pure matchups on this field, as we say. Hungary with great legs and athleticism here.
Right now, Hungary coming out playing a dominator play. There's a side stack way out of the way, just letting the handlers work their way up the field. Now the cutters are getting involved.
There's acres of space for Haris Asani.
Player was completely free. I don't know where his defender was.
Well, Austria do seem to be favoring a poach in the open lane from one of their male players at various points in this match, so perhaps that's where his matchup was. Prakash, the disc in center field, looks to her fellow handlers. Is that a timeout call?
I believe it is a timeout call. Will be a pretty high stall count, though. Not sure how many seconds exactly.
Takas Lusha there, not really looking like she had favored many of the options around her, but very static from the handlers for such a high stall situation, Ravi.
I don't think she had activated the handlers very well by really focusing in and looking at them, so that's probably why they weren't cutting quite yet. Right now, we'll see if they'll be able to clean things up. See there the sign for Jonathan. I believe that's for Harsani, the defensive all-star for Hungary so far this game.
Yeah, and the fans in the stands here in Győr are getting very loud indeed. As we, as you mentioned, Ravi, they are celebrating every single pass that's completed by this young Hungarian side. But it's great to see fans of Ultimate. On your screen, you can, of course, see the various nations in their rather saucy-looking jerseys. We've got a little shot of Germany women over there and various other, the whole German unit, I suppose, not just the German women. But they are definitely favored here in the women's division. Ravi, you've been running a picks contest.
Yes, that's true.
How do these two teams fare up? Have they got many nominations to win the bracket?
These two teams aren't quite getting too many votes to, you know, do extremely well in the picks contest. As right now you can see on your screen, the schedule we have for the next, for tomorrow. So we got lots of games there in the mixed men's, and there should be some women's games there as well, I believe, later in the day.
Indeed, there will be later on in the day. That only shows you up till 3:10 in the afternoon here in Hungary. And there we see more of the home fans. A cheeky Hugo hiding in the background of that shot.
There'll be Hugos all around the tournament this week, it seems.
Flapping their wings, throwing discs, being positive and exciting. So, Hungary pick it back up. Still a high stall. Might have to be a bailout. That's a blade and a half of a bailout. And well defended. I was surprised there not to see a chase down of that one, because the disc got hit, but it floated for a good long time.
I think Bogart didn't quite realize that she might have still had a bit on it, and maybe from our perspective, we can't exactly see how far out the back that was. Maybe it was too high while it was still in the field.
There's an argument to be had, perhaps, of if you know that the defense have position on you, maybe trying to go for the garbage collection on the other side. But Austria, with the disc back in hand, trying to take their lead, extend it to 4 points clear. Currently leading the charge 6-3, but there is a complete miscue at the back. See a head shake from Hannah Stossel.
Hungary with a very short field to work with here.
they can punch this in. They'll be back in this game.
Golden opportunity. Isolated play as Hungary throw a, well, sorry, Austria with a big poachy look. Bit of goaltending. But of course that exposes players round the back, and that's a beautiful thread of the needle. What a throw from Kazakh's Luka.
Julia Halatz there with her second goal of the game. Very sneaky, but what I loved about that was just the smile she had on her face after hearing the crowd cheer for her on that point. They are so happy to be here in their home country, showing off the best that Hungarian Ultimate has to offer right now.
And there we saw earlier that defensive play from Austria. Great extension on the pivot.
Great find there. Just had to thread the needle to get it to Julia Halatz there. But she's able to collect. 6-4. 7-3 would have been quite the deficit to get behind. But 6-4 still in it. They're still fighting. They got to get another break. I'm guessing they're going to throw that zone out again. They seem to really be favoring it. It is slowing Austria down, and it is generating turns, so you cannot fault them for that so far. It would be nice to see the D-line come out there just for once with a, you know, straight-up match defense to see how they can fair against them, but maybe in their practice games they found out that that strategy didn't work, as they lost those by much healthier margins than it seems that they're on pace to play in this game. So we do see again that zone come out here with three women. It's a bit more of a junk look here. Three women guarding the handlers and more of a person-to-person look, and able to confuse the Austrians and generate a turn.
And there we see, we were complaining earlier, Ravi, about the handlers for Austria being a little bit static, a little bit perhaps too, you know, happy to swing it around. There's a bit more energy and just throw behind the back of number 25, David Hutter. And there is a beautiful hammer opening up the breakside space. A score for Sanyi Bogar.
Sanyi Bogar with a great catch in presence of mind that was not the easiest disc to read, but very well placed. And Hungary make it 6-5, and we got a game here. Like I said, 7-3 would have been a big hole, but Hungary changing up. They haven't thrown straight up person-to-person defense, but every zone look has been slightly different. And there you're seeing they're able to just take Austria out of their comfort zone and force turns. And like I said, perhaps in the preparation games, they played too much match, realized, no, that's not going to work for us. But so far, I have to say, this Hungarian defense doing very good work to confuse the Austrians.
We talked about having a lot of energy on D, and perhaps not quite finding it on offense, but that is a very brutal way to punch in a break of score. Again, we see the disc in the hand of Paksai Marton. Is there any throw that that man can't throw deliciously?
So far, he's put a lot of flavor on every single one as Austria take another timeout here as they are flustered. They did not expect to be in this position. I know they were very confident, you know, you beat a team 15-3 and you beat a team 15-8. You probably expect it to be pretty easy, but Hungary feeding off of their junk looks, feeding off of their home crowd, doing really well here. Of course, they haven't taken the lead yet, but body language is much more confident on the Hungarian side, I have to say, right now. Austria seems flustered.
Indeed, they have the Hungarians snapping at their heels. Let's talk a little bit more about the Hungarian side. So we, obviously, a lot of them are quite young, but they still have some, well, it's a bit like another quite famous mixed team, Hut. They still have some, in air quotes, old players. We have some 25-year-olds, some 19-year-olds, some 24-year-olds, and of course the younger players who are 14 and 16, which is very, very impressive. Not been playing necessarily for that long. A couple of players with only 1 or 2 years experience, but coming out here and really showing they've got some credit. Let's talk about the number 10, Marton, who's been all over the stats boards. He's been playing for 6 years. He's one of the captains of this Hungarian side and is a former soccer player.
Honestly, 6 years is not usually the, that's usually less than I would expect for a player that's having this type of creativity on his throws. Usually that takes a little longer in your career before you start putting those up. So great on him for working on that early. And it's really, I mean, the team's kind of, without his throws, I think they wouldn't be in this position right now. As he puts the pull out there, as he gets back out there on this Hungarian defensive march as they try to bring things back to even. Coming out in another junk look. Again with three women, on the handlers is here. Austria used that over-the-top throw. It's much more effective than swinging it around.
Yeah, a tasty scuba from the hands of Christoph Schitter. Distributing nicely into the middle. He's got a great connection with Meisner. The two players just happy to work it around. Nice swinging across. Ooh, again, another potential Austrian bobble, but well kept a hold of. Oh, a hammer of their own, but that's going to be tipped away into the turf by Hungary. Great heads-up play.
Great defensive play there. Again, taking Austria out of the comfort zone. That's been the story of this game so far, and Hungary have a chance to equalize this game at 6-6. This will be their second break on the trot if they can manage it. As who else but Martin picks up the disc.
All right, I think that's the same.
A wild card, perhaps, on this Hungarian side.
And a fantastic defensive play there by Austria. Took two efforts on that disc to get the defense, but never giving up on it, even though I think he was down steps athletically, but put his hand in the right place, explosiveness, and we see Hungary come back out in the zone as Austria is forced.
Of the field, faking lots of the high throws, but choosing the conservative options. Oh, a little toss pass, nearly a miscommunication there between the Austrian players. Hütter pops back up to that far sideline. Nice inside channel to Vilavica. On the line of the end zone, knocking on that door, are Austria. Back across, Kneely. Could use the fakes to move that mark around. A Hungarian cusp must be feeling the sun beating on their necks right now. Nice shot into the middle and a lovely just little toss pass into the path of number 25, David Hütter.
They're able to move it through the cup a little more than they have been in previous points, not going over the top, not using big swings, but kind of punching through as this, like I've said, this Hungarian zone, not a lot of pressure on the throwers, just kind of biding their time, forcing a lot of throws. The whole purpose of that is to try and wait until they make a mistake. And here we saw Austria a bit more confidently saying, okay, well, we're going to take our 50-60 passes. There are 46 passes that it took them on that point. And able to do pretty well, make it 7-5.
And there you see one of the risks of playing and sticking with a zonal look so close to the end zone is once you jailbreak through that initial line of defenders, it's very easy to score, and that was a great example of that. If you are joining us here on the live stream, feel free to shout out on the live Facebook page, or you can contact us on Twitter. I'm at DiscGal31, and our stats man in the booth here today, normally you see him on the mic, we're joined by the inimitable Benji Rees, Benjamin Rees on Twitter, if you want to give him a shout. You are joining us here today for this opening game of the European Ultimate Championships 2019. So Hungary back on offense. Match look from Austria, choosing not to throw those poachers into the lane again. And there is a bobble, fortunately not able to re-grab.
And is also not gone with his person. This person is completely alone in the back of the end zone right now, completely unmarked.
Well, identifying a slow start from the Austrian side. And that's a nice play from the team in white. Oh, juke downfield, but throw had already given up on it. We'll have to lay that one, and late bid comes from Fourier and Kane. A nice attempt, but just a bridge too far to be caught.
Zerloth there trying for the kind of, sometimes called the dad backhand, lefty backhand onto the forehand side. Didn't work out for him now. As now we see an uncontested foul call, and Hungary will keep the disc. I think we see behind these players, it looks like it might be a dance squad probably coming out to do something at halftime here. I'm very excited to see what that's going to be.
I know, and our video crew do keep focusing on them. Always nice to see a little halftime show.
The pick was called here, and the question is, did that pick affect play?
I would say the angle on that throw did seem like it was doomed from the beginning, but obviously if the call did impact the thrower. Seems like it will be coming back. So Hungary back in play with their women in the handler positions at the back of the field. Really great person coverage from Austria, stifling that handler set, but separation downfield is found on those unders. Austria know by now, of course, that Hungary like to put it deep, use those bigger throws. It's a big poach off the dump, but that's going to be not chosen in favor of a big old backhand. Interesting choice there, Ravi.
Not exactly to an open person. I think she saw something that I didn't.
So Austria now with their chance to take the first half of this game, 8-5, if they can punch this one in. Currently lead by two. Frengel, far side, she's the inside. Flick to Kane. Lofty backhand over the shoulder, all along that break side. Can she fit it? No, she can't. A great attempt from Lekoschek, but not to be.
Hungary getting another chance here to bring this game back within one.
Oh, correction, that was Schmoker with that reaching bid. Would have looked sensational if she'd gotten it. Would have been a highlight reel worthy one of for sure. But Hungary tossing it up to that far sideline. Deed out of the sky by number 66, Susan Frengel.
Austria got a short field to work with after that D. Just from their attacking brick mark on the sideline.
That layout clap catch there from Fagel. Okay, puts it up to that break side. Cheeky one and a score for Austria. They take half, 8-5.
There, Florian Kane showing what his teammate couldn't do earlier. Again, that same lefty backhand to the forehand side. Seems to work out for the Austrians this time, 8-5. Now, that's a pretty big difference in score for the first half, but I have to say these teams are playing a lot closer to each other than I was going to expect. These Hungarians really showing interesting intelligence with their zones. We see that first throw that Patrick Zerloth tried to do, the backhand to the open side. Florian Kane looking at the throw, and about a couple minutes later he's going to say, hey, let me show you how to do this one. There, Schmucker not able to come down. The game winning catch, and yeah, Hungary's zone looking really good. Really frustrating the Austrians, forcing them into uncomfortable positions, getting a lot of turns. We do see a lot of inexperience on this Hungarian offensive side, as is to be expected. Some moments of brilliance as well. Of course, we have to talk about Pasai Marton is the thrower of the game for this team, for sure.
And the defensive superstar, Marisani. We'll talk about that more later as we enjoy this treat. Of athletic display.
We'll take a short break.
And so after that wonderful display of athletic, gymnastic, explosive cheerleading. I love that show. I've always envied the tumbling ability and the no fear of cheerleading. But after that lovely halftime show, we will get play back underway very shortly. But Ravi, reflecting on the first half, what would you like to see both teams do differently?
The biggest thing, if you look at some of the stats that we're able to see here about the two teams, is the difference in the number of passes per point. You see Austria here with some points, 57 passes, 46 passes, 33 passes. Hungary never throwing more than 11 passes per point. They're really using, especially Paksai Marton's big throws into space to try and make these points finish quickly. I think they also know that they're not the most experienced team. If they threw too many passes, they might end up with an error. So they're trying to get big scores, and that's working out for them. Whereas Austria, playing through this Hungarian zone, forced into a lot of passes and eventually making a few mistakes. 9 turnovers so far from the Austrian side in this first half.
But we'll see Hungary on offense first. Maybe they can set a new pass record here as we see, again, them just isolating three handlers back. Up goes that big shot and a great read, but a fabulous defensive play from Miha Pak.
Saw the size there. Throw just a little too floaty. There was separation at the beginning, but great closing speed from Pak. And once Pak was in the vicinity, you could see the height difference. It was going to go Austria's way.
So now Austria will bring the disc back in play, hoping to take the first break out of half. Currently a 3-point cushion. So we see far side, and immediately the big disc goes up from Leon Dovitz. Another one that's going to sit and hang here, but great boxing there from Montgomery. Launches a backhand of his own to the near side of the field, and that's an easy score right out the blocks. Pak getting bookends.
2-pass score for the Austrians. They haven't seen much out of their deep game so far this in the first half, and they're showing how to score in fewer passes, as Hungary maybe wasn't able to set their zone defense that they would have liked in that point. So taking advantage of that opportunity and showing their deep game once match defense is played against them.
Perhaps really that's why we haven't seen the Hungarian side move out of that zone look. Perhaps this is what the issue they previously experienced in their two earlier matchups in the season. But let's get another look at that beautiful defensive play from Pak. Has a little discussion at the end, actually checks with the offensive player to smooth things all over.
It's called clean in the end. Austria now up 9-5 as they break out of half here in this opening game, European Ultimate Championships 2019 in Győr, Hungary.
Working on your Győr.
Got to get that Győr. Got to get it down by the end of the week.
But talking about the actual atmosphere here now at the stadium, it seems like the gymnastic cheerleading during halftime seems to have perhaps oozed out some of the energy here. The Hungarian side not being quite as buoyed by their fans here in the stands in the stadium.
Yeah, in the first half, they were cheering on every time Austria completed, every time Hungary completed a pass.
And suddenly it looks oh so flat as we see Pak going to work once again for Austria, getting a beautiful run through D.
Didn't see Mia Pak do too much in the first half, but really coming out. Maybe he just arrived. I don't know. I didn't notice him much, making two big defensive plays to start this half off. Austria just over the border here, so a lot of these players just had to drive in to this tournament. I actually flew into Vienna yesterday.
Yeah, wonderfully positioned is Hungary in terms of hosting Ultimate Tournaments. Great to see them get the bid for the European Championships. And Austria, once again we see Hungary move back to this zone look. But still looking really calm and competent. There have been errors from Austria's side, but doesn't really always seem to be pressure stuff. But oh, that's a spicy grab at the center of the field from Montgomery. And a nice, easy pass into the center of the end zone, extending their lead to 9-5.
I mean, Hungary's got to feel a little bit bad about that, but still, they did force that risky pass. That's what they're trying to do with that zone. They're playing the zone even right in front of the end zone. We saw earlier in the last half one time where it took about 30 passes from the attacking Brickmark to finally score it in. Austria not looking like they're the most comfortable with the big overhead passes. It takes them a lot of throws before they finally risk it. And here it just barely works out for them. In other instances, they've come away with a turnover, but this time it's going to come clean as Pak with another bookends for his team.
So to briefly address this, because we're talking a lot about the youth of the Hungarian side. There are players who are a little bit older, Ravi, who play in Hungary.
Yes.
Yes.
But the strategy from Coach Zoltán is to prepare a team for, I believe he's eyeing 2024 World Ultimate Glass Championships and maybe even 2028 Olympics. So he has decided to put together a team of young players. He says that his philosophy is that a national team spot is a responsibility, not a reward. So it's a responsibility to build the Hungarian national side, and he thinks he can do that with younger players. There are a couple clubs, LOL and Freebies, that are completely absent from this team. A little bit of controversial decision on that, but they were not allowed to participate. And now Hungary will come back out on it.
Well, I tell you what, Ravi, if this is what the players from Hungary can do at the ages, well, basically a team of mostly teenagers with this few playing experience can bring out on this stage, I'm very excited to see their potential in the years to come. Not the cleanest bid there, but I feel like this is probably going to go back.
No, it was an uncontested foul, so the disc should stay. There was a bit of contact, and their number three, Luka Taks, not able to wrap her hands around it, but with the uncontested, she keeps disc.
And then we see another big wrapper of a backhand into the space. Austria caught snoozing there. I don't even think the intended target knew that that disc was coming until the very last minute. But what a way to score.
I think that's Melinda Kolar-Nagy with the score. Great rundown, great focus to catch that one. It was not an easy disc to read. Was that Marton with the throw again?
I believe it was. He takes his fifth assist of this game. Sixth assist.
No, that is his fifth.
Fifth? Fifth, sixth?
Fifth assist. Fifth assist.
Well, I don't know. We might be missing one of our stats on our screen. So currently it's 10-6.
Yeah, there was Luka Tach got one of the assists in the game, and he has got the other five.
Oh, there we go. Five. Five assists. But clearly a dominant thrower for sure. Talking actually about the gymnastic display we had at halftime, currently Gior is actually host to the junior gymnastic championships, and one of their team, Jonathan Harsanyi, who we saw a beautiful banner in the stands for earlier, he actually is a former gymnast himself.
That was a fantastic pull there. That was again from Paksai Marton, of course. Deep into the back corner of the end zone. Austria now. Big shot.
Complete lack of respect there from the defender, just allowing them to go deep, and that gets punished devastatingly. Score in the hands of Hochmeier.
Again, good stuff from the Austrians. I believe don't know if Hungary came out in a bit of a zone look or that was more of a match defense there, because it seems that whenever they go match, Austria goes deep and it's worked out, which explains why Hungary keeps playing their zone.
For sure. So Austria with an extensive lead, 5 points, currently charging ahead 11-6. But this was the separation that confused me. The defender just seemed to watch Meisner just run deep and not really do anything to try and hustle or prevent that pass until the throw had already gone up.
It's maybe the type of throw where the defender thought, okay, my player's already too far back. The huck's not going to come up. Let me try and poach in on the under, see if I can cause some havoc there. But, you know, maybe still in the mentality of playing a bit of zone, playing a bit of junk, and not really focusing on his matchup there.
But game is still alive. A 5-point deficit, whilst hard, is not insurmountable by any means. Stack getting involved in the isolation from the Hungarian handlers. Oh, and a nice idea, but unfortunately miscommunicated. The handler not really looking for that play at all. Just sails past Anna Patzendorf. So a very short field opportunity here for Austria. Choosing an isolation play at the front of the end zone on Montgomery, who pops it up that line. A score for Austria. They extend their lead to a full 6 points strong, 12-6.
Now doubling the score of the Hungarians. It's a bit more what we expected from this game, as we said before that these two teams have played twice earlier this season. Those two games going 15-8 and 15-3, both in favor of Austria. Now 12-6 up and looking to make a statement in their opening game. Looking a bit at the pools and how things are set up, this is, as we said before, a 19-team division, which doesn't make for the most mathematically consistent pool system, but they have three pools of five, one pool of four. The Austrians and the Hungarians are both in Pool XB. They'll be joined by Great Britain, Sweden, and Lithuania. Top two in the pool will advance to power pools. You can still make your way into the bracket from the lower pools, but it's a lot harder of a road to get there, so every win's going to count here in this pool. And looks like Austria is on their way to getting their first win, but we'll see what Hungary has to say about that as they bring their O-line back out.
Well, it ain't over till it's over, Ravi. I'd love to get a bit more from the sidelines here with the once very loud set of fans who seem to have gone oh so quiet as we see the disc just sailing into the turf. Harsanyi has been so effective for Hungary, but unfortunately he can't even get his long limbs around that one.
Error is just creeping in for this Hungarian side. They were playing very, very smoothly and very safely in the first half. I mean, of course, great throws, but not making as many errors as here. They will be granted another chance as the Austrian player just misreads that one and tips off his hands.
That is a gift indeed, back into the hands of Hungary. We see there's a slight change in their offensive look. They are now choosing to have only two handlers back rather than the three, but abusing the poach of the Austrian side. Oh, and a great backup there. Not sure that that was the intended target whatsoever. Hungary just putting it up into the space, just trying to put people behind it. Nice up-line cut, but just enough pressure. An Austrian sandwich there, causing the disc to be a bit too much of an ask. I think that was Zubody trying to chase that one down.
Adrian Ernst there with great up-line defense to put pressure on that catch, as now Austria look to extend their lead even further here.
Ultz. She's the up-line, near side. Kane. Very static offense from Austria right now. Nice pop-up over the head, though. Zerloth finds the reaching hands of Kine. Schneister back to Kine. Oh, and a nice inside low release lefty backhand. That's a lovely way to score. Teresa Ulch reeling it in, extending the lead 13-6.
A couple contested throws near the end there, but really as they marched it down the field, Austria had great separation. It was just giving and going and dinking and dunking all the way down the field. Great small ball offense there by the Austrians, as we had seen them earlier play a lot more with the big hucking game. They're showing they can do it both ways here. 13-6 now as they extend their lead to 7 points again. Great catch there, though, by the Hungarian.
Yeah, that looked like it hurt a little bit, just a full face full of grass. But fab composure, keeping hold of it. As I said, it just seems like the Hungarian offense right now is sort of just evolved into putting it into the space on the break side, and someone, somewhere will catch it.
We do see here another timeout being called. I'm curious what you think about this. Every timeout that's been called so far, Austria has been rushing over to the shade while Hungary staying out in the sun, maybe trying to gain the energy they can from their crowd, whereas Austria trying to reserve their energy for the game. What do you think about these two strategies in terms of where to place yourself during a timeout?
I am a huge fan of the shade, Ravi.
I'm shocked by that. That answer.
Being as so pale that I'm in places see-through, Rav. I'm a big fan of keeping in the cool. Not only for the kind of, obviously, the physical benefits of when you're running around on the field, there's no escape from the sun, apart from on that very thin channel of the far sideline. You're running around, you're sweating, you're getting hot-headed, and actually having the opportunity, especially during a timeout, if you are currently in Austria's position, as you say, they need to stay cool, stay calm, collected. If you're Hungary, maybe you do want to try and fuel the power of the sun to try and, you know, get that energy up, but I think maybe, I mean, I'm just a big fan of cooling things off, not trying to be too feisty, and also not burning. Big fan of not being sunburned.
Well, that's not something they're not using sunscreen, so something they're going to avoid this week. It's going to be a lot of sun out here in Győr all week long. Luckily, in our commentary spot, at least on Field 1, we got a lot of shade. You can hang out in the cool shade of the stadium.
There's a tiny bit of breeze. We've actually seen an ever so slight change in conditions from the beginnings of this game, where it was, well, I can't think of a metaphor, but it was very still. And now there's just the gentle caress of the breeze from the right hand side of the field to the left. But Austria now 2 points away from taking this opener. Their D line coming out. We'll have to prevent Hungary, who've gone back to having three set back. Great give goes between their young women. Bulgar. Stakac. Nice inside backhand, but that's going to sail too far. Picked out of the sky by Adrian Ernst.
And it's just execution errors out of Hungary so far this half, whether it's a throwing error, a drop, just or a bad throwing decision. They're not really getting D'd by Austria. They're not really getting, you know, outran or anything. It's just execution.
Oh, and that's a lovely bit of timing there. A tiny bit too much hang on that throw, but well scored, reeled in by Julia Schmeisser. Sorry, Suzanne Frenkel even.
Anna Patzendorf there. A little bit of a physical play on her side, but trying to take everything she can to extend this momentous occasion for the Hungarian team to play in front of such a large home crowd, as Austria's looking to put an end to that as quickly as possible. 14-6 now, as Hungary has just been able to score 1 point so far in the second half. Very different from what we saw in the first half. And like I said in that point, it's execution errors. Hungary just unable to execute on offense right now.
As we hear the fans starting to get behind the home side once more, the drum is being beaten. But is it the march towards the end of this game as we see Austria's D-line coming out once more? Hungary need to keep this one alive. Going back to that two set back. Marton disc in his hands. Such a capable thrower. Chooses the reset. Isolated upfield. Oh, and there's some hot defense from Austria. Foul's going to be called. Andras Mareda.
Did see some pressure on the back of the Hungarian player there. This foul will be uncontested. I think that's a fair call.
Yeah, 14-year-old on the disc, Mareda. Going to put it up. Bit of a huck and hope. Receiver had position, but nice explosivity from Julia Smeisser.
Austria now with a chance to put the game away and end this opening match at EUC 2019, and they take it. Austria win the first game here in Győr, 15-6 against the Hungarians.
And what a second half that was, Ravi. Just absolutely smothering Hungary, and with a flourish at the end, choosing the throw that the Hungarian offense used so well earlier in the game, that inside flick shot to that far corner of that right-hand end zone. Dominant performance. They'll be happy with that.
Hungary just couldn't get themselves geared up for this second half. They couldn't get the execution. They couldn't get the offensive holds. And because of that, they weren't able to come down on defense with their complicated zone that was giving Austria so much trouble. They only had one chance to do that all half. And they came out and matched defense, actually. So didn't play their zone. We saw, look at Austria's number of passes per point here, much lower. We see two passes, three passes, maximum of 12 or 11 passes, whereas in the previous half, 46, 57 passes we saw per point. But that's going to be the difference in this second half, and Austria win the first game, 15-6. Stick around all week. We got plenty of action, as we'll be back tomorrow with more from Győr.
Thank you.
Le Coq.
We wish you a